these guys get attention on them. They hold it down, lay it all on the line. A true seasoned vet. He's looking all right. We'll see how he ends up. We're going to get him on there. Chris, how would you describe what just happened? Did he miss a hand? Or I know freestyle motocross is one of the most dangerous sports you can do, but from a true expert's eye, what just happened?
Yeah, I think the ramp maybe kicked him a little funky and went for the grab anyway, and his bike was kind of nose down. It looked like he panicked, his hand slipped off the grab there. And then from there, it's just a ride to the ground, trying to get away from the bike.
All right, now Tim Jones, how'd your night in racing go? I seen you out here jamming around. I was in the back getting my Q&A's ready for later tonight, but how's your night going?
Oh, you know, I'm racing, you know, I let Jack get in my head a little bit. He was back there smack talking about how he's going to show me up since I advanced in the second round of racing. But, and I did, I got down there and slipped out. It's a little grippy down here as I see their crew kind of hike up. So I come around and I felt the hook, and then I got down there and it spun out on me. And, you know, and then Jack got the best of us there. But we went back and got locked in, get his truck all back together. So he's going to be 100% freestyle and ready to burn it down against the rest of us.
I know we're looking forward to it. Now, we know you're more of an old school driver, more of a full send driver, but we see you pop on the nose. The only way to get over these steep obstacles this evening. What was that like, bouncing a 12,000 pound truck up on the nose?
Well, you know, that I'm not one to take risks like that. I like the old muleys, but these guys, they thought it was a little funny than last night to come in here, make these ramps steeper, make them taller, and, you know, give you guys a little bit of a carnage show. And so I played with it. And I went ahead and I tried to stop me. I figured if I'm going to crash, I'm going to crash and try something new. Going into freestyle, you know, we've done pretty good just being consistent and making rounds. As you guys all seen, you know, Lockhead losing axles right there in wheelies and losing the whole round of racing. That's 30 points that he lost right off the get-go. So his big significant thing, he's putting right down there with me. And that's where I'm like, I knew last year when I played this game with these guys in points that I had to just be consistent and make my rounds. Being broke doesn't win me the overall championship. And I mean, I got some time to make up that lost ground, but it is Saturday night. We got a couple weeks off of the toughest tour, so I'm ready to go out and have some fun.
There we go. I know we're all looking forward to it. Now, TJ, how would you describe this track? Because we got about 20-foot hole mound. We got steep jumps, and I see some hidden surprises back in that corner.
Yeah, you know, this jump here gets a little intimidating, especially when you're coming at it from that side and then jumping to down it. You know, we kind of go at it that way. Last night, you know, we kind of wasn't shooting the trucks out and shot them straight up. I see that it did change the transition a little bit, so hopefully we can get some insane air and give you guys a heck of a show.
There we go. I know we're all looking forward to it. Three Sanford, let's get some noise for the man himself, TJ, and the driver of the tailgater.